Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be my June empties. I have actually a ton. This basket is honestly overflowing. I have a few things on my desk just because it would not all fit in that one basket. So I have a lot of stuff to show you guys. So buckle up, sit down, grab a tea, grab a coffee, get a snack. It's gonna be a while. I'll try to keep it short, but I have so much to show you guys. So Kai has decided to join us, but let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna start with actually a bunch of wax melts. I was pretty much aiming for the month of June to finish off most of my stash of wax melts. One, because I just wanna start getting some new scents. And two, because I know fall's coming up and I'm gonna wanna buy some really great scents when fall comes around. And I think the Scentsy fall launch is like August 1st, so I'm kind of preparing my collection, but yeah, finished off so many. So let's get started with these. Okay, first I did finish off my 3-pack from Easter, from April, but the first was lemon drizzle cake. This was really good, basically iced lemon pound cake. Raspberry lollipop, which was just like a super sweet candy scent. I could see them like repackaging this for Halloween and just call it like a bucket of candy or something. And then blueberry burst, which is really yummy. I love mixing this with vanilla, what is it? Vanilla bean buttercream, which I also finished off. This one's so good. Just a standard, and I need to restock on this one, but it was really, really yummy. Some pink ones that I have, finished off watermelon wave, really good. I definitely smelled the watermelon rind in this one, which is kind of unique. Strawberry swirl, which I absolutely loved. I love strawberry scents. And this was just the icing on the cake. It smells like a strawberry puree or like strawberry jelly. It smells so good. And then pink haze, which was just like a fresh bedroom scent with a little bit of fruit. So that one was good too, nothing crazy. I have a few citrusy scents. We've got cocoa lime, which is just straight up lime. This is from last year, actually. I needed to get that one finished. And pineapple sorbet, which was really, really nice. Kind of reminds me of the pineapple s'mores candle that Bath & Body Works has out right now. So really, really yummy. Super like juicy pineapple smelling. And then the last three Scentsy ones, I have clementine cupcake, which was really yummy. Just basically like vanilla cupcake with some orange in it. Coconut cotton, which I definitely will repurchase for the bedroom. This is like a really nice laundry scent. And then rainbows and butterflies, which is just like a sweet fruity scent. And the last wax melt I have is actually from Mainstays and blueberry sorbet. Nothing special. It was like those little bitty 97 cent clamshells, but still just like a nice blueberry scent and I enjoyed it. Let's get into some candles. So first I finished off Hello Gorgeous Pumpkin Spice Latte. Really happy to have finished off this single wick because this will be the last like single wick that I buy that's not meant for either my bedroom upstairs or my bathroom upstairs. So Pumpkin Spice Latte was really yummy. Great performer. I had it in my project wax. I probably won't repurchase it in a single wick, but I definitely would do it in a 3-wick, which it is coming back for fall, so I probably will pick that up. Next, I finished off Strawberry Daiquiri. This one honestly was like nothing special. It was a great burner. It was like a hot burner. It had great wicks. It did not tunnel. It did not soot or anything like that, but it wasn't the best scent ever. It was maybe like a 6 on strength. But the notes are frozen strawberries, sweet simple syrup, shot of tropical rum, and zesty citrus twist. It just smelled like champagne toast to me, maybe with like some strawberry element in it. But that's all it really smelled like to me, so nothing special. I do like champagne toast though, so I'll continue to repurchase those, but I definitely wouldn't get that one again. Next, I have blueberry pie, which I've bought pretty much every year since it came out in 2019. The notes are juicy blueberries, flaky crust, and sugar crystals. This one, however, was like a pretty poor burner. The wicks were always like a little too short and it didn't really matter if I trimmed them or not. They were always like a little too short and the flame was really light and it was super sooty and it wasn't the strongest thrower, but I love the scent so much, so it's kind of worth it. But yeah, I'll still repurchase them next year. I just hope that the candle next year performs a little better than this one, but that was that one. And then I did also finish off coconut cream pie. Love, love, loved this one. The notes are toasted coconut flakes, caramel custard, and golden pie crust. You really get the caramel in the home fragrance versus the body care. Oh, this was a delicious scent. Beautiful burn, beautiful scent. A little sooty, but not too much. Not too much in my opinion to where I didn't want to burn it. So really, really good scent, would definitely get it again. And the last candle that I finished off this month, making that 5 total, is Champagne Margarita, which I absolutely adored. The notes are sweet lime, champagne, and sugar cane. This one was so good. A great burner, probably about a 7 or 8 on throw. Beautiful, beautiful scent. Basically like margarita with a bit of like a bubbly aftertaste, after smell, whatever. So good, so yummy. I really, really like this one. So I definitely would repurchase it if they brought it out next year. Sadly, I don't think they would because I didn't hear a lot of people talk about it, but I absolutely adored this. I have a few home fragrance wallflowers. I have a mahogany coconut right here. We had this in our hallway upstairs. And it was really good. It's basically just like a coconutty, but like mixed with mahogany teakwood. So it was really nice upstairs, like to have a nice relaxing scent. And then we have Market Peach and Strawberry Pound Cake downstairs in like the foyer right when you walk in. So yummy. It's like a very sweet, decadent, fruity scent. It's so good. And then we also finished off a little Glade plug-in refill. So that's it for home fragrance. Let's move into body care. Super exciting stuff here. I did finish off a full-size body scrub from Onyx Bath House. This is the Dim Buns Dough body scrub. I've been working on this for like 6 months. I don't know, like a long time, okay? But I only can use this once a month because it's super, super coarse. So I just use this once a month, not month, once a week when I shower and shave. So yeah, it's really just like a straight up cinnamon scent, super strong cinnamon. Oh my God, so strong, but really, really good. And I have already repurchased a different scent of the body scrub. And then I did finish off a little set of raspberry jam donut in the shower gel and in the body cream. So I loved this scent. In the shower gel, it was kind of underwhelming. It didn't have the best throw, like you could barely smell it. But in the body cream, it was so delicious and decadent and just amazing. I loved it in the body cream. So totally, totally good. And then I finished off a little strawberry pound cake hand cream. Really enjoyed this. You can never go wrong with strawberry pound cake, and I love their formula. So enjoyed that one. Another mini that I finished off is Copper Coconut Sands. I really like this one. It's basically like a bubbly coconut scent. I used it on vacation. It was really nice. I definitely don't need to like repurchase it or buy more, but I liked it while I had it and I did enjoy it. Another body care item, I used the EOS Shea Butter Shave Cream for dry skin. Really, really liked this. I just repurchased their shaving cream, but in the pump. So we'll see how that works, but I really did like this one. It was super moisturizing. And then I did finish off the Village Naturals Therapy Aches and Pains Muscle Relief Bath Soap, just like bath salts. I think they were green. I did like these. They weren't anything crazy. I'll just stick to regular bath salts from now on, but it was nice to try. And then I did finish off 3 hand soaps this month. So I finished off an H-E-B Peach Bellini, nothing special. I just bought these whenever I didn't want to go to Bath & Body Works anymore. So this one was at our kitchen sink, finished that one off. Finished off the Method Pink Grapefruit. I actually really enjoyed this formula and the scent of this one. I picked it up for $3 at Ross, so a good deal on that one. And then Bath & Body Works Pistachio Cream Puff is the last one that we finished off. This one was so yummy. I almost considered getting a second, but I thought I would get a little sick of it. But it's so good. I did not know that I liked pistachio scents until I tried this one, so that was really good. All right, a little bit of hair care. The first thing I have here is Joico Moisture Recovery Moisturizing Shampoo. I love the shampoo and conditioner from them in this line. It is so good, especially if you have dandruff or even if you want just to moisturize your hair. So, so, so good. I know it's expensive, but it's really worth it, especially if you can find it at like Marshall's or TJ Maxx. They can have these on really good deals. Another thing that's great for somebody who has scalp issues is the Love Beauty and Planet Charcoal and Bergamot Sulfate-Free Shampoo Scrub. I love this stuff. I've repurchased it time and time again for years now. It's my absolute favorite and I really enjoy it. Totally recommend if you're having scalp problems. And the last little hair thing is the Briogeo Farewell Frizz Leave-In Conditioner. I actually really like this. I did not want to bite the bullet and buy this like $35 leave-in conditioner, so I didn't buy it. But it is really nice, and I would consider it in the future if it was like on sale or something. All right, we got makeup and skincare, and then we're done, okay? I have the Milani Make It Last Original Natural Finish Setting Spray. I love this stuff. I've used it for years now. It is my favorite setting spray, so I have already repurchased that one. And then I have a few Mary Kay things. I have the under eye corrector from them. I go through this stuff like water. I use it every single day under my eyes. It's just like a pinky corrector, and I've already repurchased it and I'm already using it again. I absolutely adore it. And then I finished off the Lash Love Fanorama Mascara, also from Mary Kay. Really, really good. I love the bristles on this brush. It's so nice. It just dried out on me after having it for a few months. So need to repurchase another one of these, but I loved it. And then this also dried out on me. It's the Ico Skinny Liquid Eyeliner in black. So I have to declutter it because I can't use it anymore. And then I did also finish off the Burt's Bees Pomegranate Lip Balm. Honestly, I like the scent of it. It smelled really good, but this did not really moisturize my lips at all. And if anything, it almost made them drier. So I won't be purchasing Burt's Bees lip balms again, but I did like the scent. All right, last category is skincare. I finished off a Tony Moly Aloe Sheet Mask and really loved it. I use like one of these per month just on like a pamper day, and I do like them. They're good for the price. I finished off a Arcona Cleanser and White Tea Purifying Cleanser is what it says. I got this as a mini from like Ulta during some sort of giveaway or something. It was fine, whatever. I just wanted to finish it up, honestly. And then I also finished off a NYX micellar water. I get this for $6 on Amazon. It's such a good deal. I absolutely adore this. I use it every single day to take off my makeup, and I've already repurchased it. So, and the last thing that I finished up in the month of June is the Mary Kay Clinical Solutions C Plus Resveratrol Line Reducer. It's basically a vitamin C serum, and I absolutely adore it. I've already repurchased it. It works wonders for like evening complexion. I had some like acne scarring from a few breakouts that I had before and some like hyperpigmentation and stuff. Beautiful. It worked wonders. So I absolutely love it, and I will continue to use that. So yeah, that is everything for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, like, comment, and subscribe down below, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.